The infrastructure in the United States is the envy of the world.
People don't realize how complicated our electric infrastructure is.
The grid is moving faster and there's more happening on it, so we have to have a better handle on what's going on.
The utility of the past is changing.
The change is coming at us. It's a big deal.
It's about empowering our customers.
We want to stay relevant. We want to continue to control our destiny.
The modern grid would be a platform for enabling the 21st century economy.
This project has been, in many ways, a massive undertaking, working with 11 utilities, 6 technology providers, BPA, to test new technology here in the Pacific Northwest.
There's a wide range of technology that we piloted in our smart city.
Communicating with our customers and helping them understand what we were doing in Pullman was really critical.
We're very active in the community.
Paint that picture in advance.
And thermostats were one of our most more challenging elements because we really had to get in front of customers.
We were interested in the technology, being able to adjust the thermostat from anywhere using our phones. I like participating in the research and also the incentive.
To help them understand how the system worked was really probably one of the biggest challenges.
We had very few complaints because we addressed those issues up front.
Smart Grid Now for us is really just grid modernization.
It's really exciting, that visibility into our system that we haven't had before. We actually just hit our 1 million avoided outage minute.
We've been metering electricity for over 100 years in Idaho Falls.
Everything I've read says that our grid in the United States needs upgrading.
It really is so important to think about customer engagement on this.
Is this getting information from the meter?
It is. It's communicating with the meter.
We've learned that we need to reach out to our customers for one more in outreach and education, which has been a large focus of this project.
I think anything smart we've decided is probably a bad word to run with.
We have a kind of a vocal minority that is opposed to these meters.
We do remind folks of we're collecting the same data we always have, using it in the same way we always have. This is going to open up an opportunity for you to see the data and you to be able to make decisions based on that data now.
I've just been curious how my energy usage is going in the house, and the meter allows me to track that.
We had a series of information meetings last year to address the issues.
I'm excited about it because I really think that the technology opens up a whole new opportunity for customer service.
Generally in favor of it, but I don't have a lot of information. I've looked at the climate data. I believe we're going to have more extreme weather. We're likely to have more outages because of climate change.
It's going to really put them in the driver's seat.
The idea of somebody controlling my water heater was a bit of a foreign concept to a lot of Wyoming and Southeast Idaho customers.
We have very little businesses here except the post office and a gas station and the cafe. The post office seems to be the center of the news and the place to be to have conversation. Since we had signed up for the water heater program specifically, I've told quite a few neighbors and people in the community about it as well.
The town of Jackson is a small municipality, a little town, responsible for hosting about 30,000 daily visitors all summer long. Smart grid technology is brilliant. You know, working with our utility, Lower Valley Energy, we're moving in that direction.
If it's helping Lower Valley and helping us, I think it's a great program.
They tend to trust us because we've got a proven track record with them.
Economically, it makes sense. Environmentally, you know, reducing our carbon footprint is good for business.
It's a change in the relationship with electricity.
It means that we actually can manage a system better, but being very cost effective and efficient in how we operate the electric grid. Over the last 5 years, we've invested $9.5 billion in technologies in the electric infrastructure in partnership with over 250 different utilities.
We were implementing technologies that we had never seen before.
They were very courageous, way outside their comfort zone in doing that, and it's very much appreciated.
The most pleasant surprise is everything that we demonstrated actually works. The transactive node, the economic dispatch of energy, that has worked extremely well.
We got a lot further, a lot faster than we would have had we been on our own.
That is good for consumers. It is good for the climate.
We've only just opened the door And our investments really are a catalyst, I think, to what's to come.
We all need to pay very careful attention and try to anticipate things, because there will be twists and turns in this plot that we may not have anticipated yet.
It's only the beginning of the story, really.
Clear. You can return that to normal. And I'm done.